Hello everyone, and welcome to the new InDesign tutorial series. In this series, I will be teaching you how to make academic posters with InDesign CS6. If you go to conferences as a scientist or engineer, you often need to bring your own poster to present your research. I think most people don't really enjoy making posters, so if you look at posters on the internet or on conferences where you are going, most of the times it's just a big wall of text and not very nice to look at. So I want you to remember that posters are something visual. So in this tutorial, I'm not only going to talk about how to get the right amount of text, but also how to get the very nice flow and layout, and also how to use figures and graphics to make your poster very attractive. If you need to make a poster for a conference, I really hope you see this as an opportunity to design something, to create something, to be a little bit of an artist. Even if you are a scientist, I think everyone can have a lot of fun making a poster, and it's great if it looks very nice in the end, because a great poster will help to also promote your research. So in this course, I will be helping you to make a great poster. But before we start making the poster, I want you to consider some key things before you open up InDesign. First of all, you should really figure out who is attending the conference. Is it a very specialized conference on only neuroscience or a particular group of organisms, or has the conference a very broad field? So depending on that, you will have some expert from your field, or you will have general students or professors from other fields as well, and you need to adjust the style and the information in your posters accordingly. So if the conference is for a general audience, you want to keep it very simple and don't use special terms that only people from your field are using. Secondly, figure out the actual dimensions of your poster. On conferences, you get only one specific wall where you can put your poster on, and if your poster is too big, you will not be able to hang it on your poster wall. So usually posters are in A1 or A0, and also think about if the poster needs to be in landscape or if it can be in the normal orientation. You will find those informations on the conference website or if you apply for a conference. Now, as you know the size and orientation of your poster, it's really important that you make a draft. So take out a piece of paper and make a rough sketch with what you want to put on your poster and also which sections you want to have, like introduction, materials and methods, and how much space they should take on your poster. Normally, the results section should have the biggest space on the poster, and as we are making a poster in this tutorial as well, I have done this for the poster we will make. So you should have an idea what your layout should look like and what contents should go on your poster. It's really key here to concentrate your research to the most important points only, because if you don't do this, you will end up with a wall of text. Also try to keep it to 300 words total on your poster. If you end up with 400, well, that's all right. But if you really then go across 400, you need to scrape something away. So really try here to aim for 300 words, and don't forget that the poster should be a lot more visible and not written like a thesis with a lot of words. Now, as you have figured out what you want to put on your poster, you should maybe also discuss this with your supervisor. And then one last important point is that you should not worry too much about details now. The first step is, as we have our draft, to get our text and figures into InDesign to get a basic overview if our layout idea works and how everything looks together. And then we can work on the details and polish the poster and really choose the right font size, choose the right font, and so on. Work on all the edges. So make sure to get the content on the poster first and then tweak all the layout and make everything look very nice. All right, I hope you will keep this checklist in mind, and in the next video, I will show you some posters I made and also talk about how to get inspired to create your own poster and your own style. So click here for the next video.